All right, business news now. We're going over to Mike Eppel, and we're talking about how it was not a great start to the week. Let's hope things turn around a little bit, especially here with the TSX.
Yeah, indeed. Good morning, Melanie. Keep in mind, though, that as of Friday last week, we had seen, I think, the 13th record of January on the blue chip stock average, the Dow Jones Industrial Average. So the party, was expected to end at some point, and maybe we're just blowing off some steam a little bit here on the financial markets after what has been a pretty strong start to the year. The Dow yesterday was down 177, TSX down 144. It's now negative for the year, whereas Wall Street benchmarks are still up about 7%. What's happening here, though, is bond yields have been going up, and again, markets do not go up in a straight line despite what you've seen over pretty much the past 12 months in the U.S. trading. So right now we're looking at a pullback for the Wall Street market at the opening bell of another 150 points. And one of the bellwethers, Apple, is indicated to start at $166 a share. It peaked at $180 just a couple of weeks back. Apple reports earnings on Thursday, and they could be talking about a little bit of a slowdown in the earlier production targets for the iPhone X. Marijuana mania. Another day, another deal on Bay Street. Yesterday it was Afria, buying Nuvera Corp for over $800 million. Multi-million dollar valuations on these cannabis companies, which are looking at the global market as weed becomes legalized here in Canada later this year and more so in other jurisdictions around the world. And those stocks on the TSX heavily traded once again. Is the Toronto's real estate market now in a bit of a deep freeze? January is a typically slow month, but some indications as we come to month's end that this start of the year has been particularly slow for the real estate market after some new rules put into effect at the start of the year for tightening mortgage requirement restrictions. And of course, mortgage rates have been going up. Now, again, it's based on a pocket. You know, you look at various pockets of the city, still strong, others are weaker, but it is more of a buyer's marketplace. Oil everywhere and no place to put it. Suncor announcing yesterday they've raised production at their oil sands operations in Fort Hills, north of Edmonton. And the problem? Well, the pipelines are at capacity and so are the rail delivery platforms for oil. So the Canadian crude oil market is a deep discount to the U.S. Benchmark. $38 per barrel is what the U.S. The Canadian producers are getting as opposed to $65 in the States. Canadian dollar starts the day above 81 cents, and later tonight we'll be watching currency market reaction to the State of the Union address in Washington. We'll send it back to the studio.
Mike, did you get your ticket for the State of the Union address?
The one with the typo?
Yeah, here you go. This is one of the tickets.
That's amazing.
State of the Union with an M.
If you get one of those, do you have to give it back to get the new one?
They apparently didn't give them all out.
Okay.
But some of them got it.
How much would that be worth on eBay?
You can sell it. That's a good idea.
But is this an indication of how the State of the Union is going to be going? I don't know.
State of the Union.
Well, not the State of the Onion.
Yeah. Now, that's a sergeant-at-arms mistake as well. That has nothing to do with either Trump or the Democrats or anything like that. Thank you very much, Mike.